My younger son, we actually came into this room years ago, and he was probably four. And I put on my helmet on him and put my harness, and it's dragging on the floor. And he looks at me and goes, "Look, Daddy, I'm a test pilot."
Put this side in first.
I'm Nils Larson. I'm the chief test pilot here at NASA Armstrong. It really came when I was probably a junior in high school, maybe a sophomore, and one of my teachers handed me a book, and the book was The Right Stuff. I knew I kind of wanted to be an engineer or a scientist, and I read that and I went, wow, this would be cool. You could be both an engineer slash scientist, and you could be a pilot. Best of both worlds, how cool would this be?
Roll 3, 2. Copy, Mark.
The test pilot answer is my favorite is whatever I'm flying today. So I just got out of the F-18, so that's my favorite right now.
Well, the role of the test pilot is to pull it all together in the air. Our mission here, our objectives are testing science and technology through flight, in flight.
Let's see, flight objectives. Basically, the biggest thing is to try and get this instrumentation worked out and, you know, be able to compare it to the airplane and to what's being recorded on my chest. Mission security, mission rules, go, no go. We talked about the 40,000 foot, probably the biggest one. So we'll go to 39,999 feet. Let's see.
Keep me on my toes.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay. You got your helmet?
Okay, I'll give you the rundown real quick and then we can go out there and do what we got to do.
Well, what we do is our initial concern is to give the pilot a safe and reliable aircraft for his mission. Once we've achieved that, then our next concern becomes the science and the research folks that are going to be associated with the airplane. So if they've attached an experiment or they're looking for specific data, we work with them to make sure that their equipment is working the way it should be and that it gets them the data that they're looking for.
You know, for us here, we work a lot more with a project. We're doing, you know, sometimes we call it weird things with airplanes. So rarely are we going to point A to point B, or if we are going point A to point B, we're going up and down and up and down and up and down the whole time when we're going there. And our job is to try and get the people the data.
Fan of the speed brake. See how it's effect on pitch.
Whoa. That was a good one.
You look and, you know, you still, even though you're sitting in the same desk, you know, Neil Armstrong worked here. We named the place after him. You know, my desk used to be right where he sat. You know, Joe Walker, you know, I sit where his desk used to be. That's where I sit now. And you still don't feel like you're worthy to be sitting where they were.
Air Pro 2.
I'll say one thing. These pilots are about the best test pilots probably in the world. They're very busy. They're either flying all across the world in sims, meetings, tech briefs. They make things happen at NASA and for the United States and the world. They're the first people flying maybe a wing that was modified or some modification to an aircraft.
We're not done with flight. There's a lot of research yet to be done in flight. There's a lot of gains yet to be accomplished in flight. And to get our job done, we need test pilots like Nils Larson, like the people he works with and trains.
Still a little bit of side-to-side motion on the stick, a little bit of pumping forward.
It's early morning and I'm watching the sunrise over the lake bed, and it's a beautiful sunrise, and it suddenly occurs to me, oh my God, I made it. You know, I'm doing what it was that I decided when I was 16 that I wanted to go do. I always tell people that it's worth it, because it wasn't like I was just nosing the book, you know, for 17 years. I had a lot of fun in those 17 years getting up to that flight. And then I've had a lot more flights like that since. So, you know, it's totally been worth it.